Hello, my dear students. Good morning, all of you. Welcome for the today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. In today's lecture, we are going to learn the decimal units of measurement. Okay. Yesterday we have learned about the decimal fraction. This is the application of decimal fraction or decimal numbers, where we can use this decimal point. Okay. Now the measure means what? You know, we know to measure length or weight or capacity. Length, generally we measure length, weight and capacity. Okay, length means what? Length means how much the thing is long, or the distance between two cities, two places. Okay, whereas weight means the heaviness of the object. For example, your weight is 45 kg, 50 kg, or the weight of sugar is 1 kg. I brought 5 kg rice from the market. Weight. Okay, and the capacity means this term is related with the liquid things. When we measure any liquid things like milk, then how we measure? Using the vessels, that those vessels have some capacity, particular capacity, and that can be measured in the liter, right? 1 liter milk, 2 liters milk. Okay, so when we are going to measure length, weight and capacity, we use different types of units. When we talk about standard units of measurement, standard unit of measurement for length, the standard unit is meter. What it is? Meter. M-E-T-E-R. Meter is the standard unit of length. Whenever we measure length, we say it is 2 meter, 3 meter. However, there are other units also that I am going to explain you. These are the standard unit, meter. For weight, the standard unit is gram. Okay. And for capacity, the standard unit is liter. Keep it in mind. Whenever we measure length, the standard unit for length is meters, the standard unit for weight is gram, the standard unit for capacity is nothing but liter. Okay. Now, if the object is smaller than the meter, or small objects, smaller in length, to measure those smaller objects, we have other units. Also, if the distance is too much far, okay, for more distance, to measure large distance, we have big units also. Which are those big units? See, before meter, there are 3 small units. The smallest one is millimeter. Okay, then there is centimeter. Then there is decimeter. Means these suffixes, prefixes are used, milli, centi and deci, before meter. Okay, these 3 units are smaller than meter, whereas 3 units are bigger than meter. Which are those bigger? Decameter. Decameter, hectometer and kilometer. Kilometer. Understood? So these 3 units are bigger to measure longer distance than the meter. Understood? Similarly, for gram also there are 3 units, smaller units than gram and 3 bigger units than gram. Smaller are same, the same prefixes are used before gram, milligram, centigram and decigram. Whereas greater than gram or decagram, hectogram and kilogram. In short, milligram is written as mg, centigram is written as cg, decigram is written as dg, okay, and gram is written as g, decagram is written as this way, deca g. We cannot write d because there is d for deci, okay. Then here hg, hectogram, and kg for kilogram. This is the this unit you have seen many times, kg, kilogram. Same for this, millimeter, mm. Then cm, centimeter means cm, dm, decimeter, here m, deca m, okay, hm, hectometer, not headmaster, km, kilometer, km, okay. Similarly for liter also we have three small units, three big units. Three small units are same, milliliter, then we have centiliter and we have deciliter, okay. And after liter we have decaliter, then there is hectoliter and kiloliter, okay. Understood? This can be in short written as a ml, cl, centiliter, dl, deciliter, liter, then we have deca liter, hl, hectoliter, and km, kiloliter, okay. These are the short forms used to express these units. Now see, if you keep these units in your mind, these are same, all these units are same. What you have to keep it in mind, just this standard unit. Standard unit for length is meter, standard unit for weight is gram, and standard unit for capacity is liter. Or else are same. See, this milli centi deci. Here just you will add suffix meter, 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 gram, 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 liter, liter, liter. Okay. Same here, deca, hecto, kilo, deca, hecto, kilo are same. Here meter, deca, meter, 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 gram, 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 liter, liter, liter. Okay. So this sequence you have to keep it in mind. This sequence you have to keep it in mind. Now pause this video. Immediately write this in your notebook. Okay. After that, see, I'm going to show you one triangle of these units that will be helpful for you to keep the that will be helpful for you to do the conversion of unit. See, many times we need to convert one unit into another. For example, we need to convert meter into kilometer, meter into centimeter. Okay. So how to convert that? Or in another example, we need to convert milligram into centigram, or milligram into gram, gram into kilogram, gram into hectogram, here liter into milliliter, or liter into kiloliter. Okay. So we can do that. We need to convert that. So to do that conversion, see this triangle I am showing you. This is very useful. If you are able to memorize this triangle, then the half work of conversion of units you have done. Okay. So see, first here milli, which is smallest. See this triangle, smallest to biggest. It is enlarging towards the bottom. And smaller, smallest unit is milli, then there is centi, then there is deci, okay. Then here, there in this layer, there are standard units. They may be meter, they can be meter, gram or liter. All these suffixes are same, millimeter, milligram, milliliter, centimeter, gram, centiliter. Okay, then after that there is deca, then there is hecto, and then there is kilo. Okay, understood? Now whenever we have to convert smaller units or bigger units to smaller, these are bigger units. Okay, it goes as it goes up, they become small and smallest at the top. Okay, now suppose when we have to convert the smaller unit to bigger, means kilo we have to convert to hecto or hecto into deca, at that time see from here we have to convert to this. Each on each level it gets multiplied with the 10. Hecto to deca again multiply with the 10, multiply with the 10, multiply with the 10, multiply with the 10, multiply with 10. Understood? Means what? If you have to convert 1 kilo to hecto, then you have to multiply 1 by 10. See, 1 kilo to hecto, only one step up we have to go, that means multiply by 10. If you have to convert kilo to deca, then you have to go 2 steps up from here and here. So this multiply by 10 and this multiply by 10. 10 tens are 100. You have to multiply with the 100. Understood? 10 tens are 100. Kilo to meter, 10 into 10 into 10. That is 10 tens are 100, tens are 1000. In this way you have to multiply. Opposite of that, if you have to convert smaller unit to bigger, then you have to come down, right? In this way. So when you have to come down, means you have to convert smaller unit to bigger, you have to divide by 10. Divide by 10 at each step, in each step, okay? Divide by 10. What is meaning of this? Same. If you have to convert milli to centi, then you have to divide by 10. If you have to convert milli to deci, then you have to divide by 10, 10 is 100. If you convert milli to this meter or gram, then 3 steps you have to come down. So 3 times 10, 10, 10, 10, that is divide by 1000. 10, 10 is 100, 10 is 1000. Okay? That I will tell you afterwards. This triangle, write down somewhere. This is very important triangle. Okay? Memorize this. If you are able to memorize this, half work is done in this chapter. Okay. After that, see, other than this, to measure weight, which is more in quantity. Suppose there are 1000 kilo rice. 1000 kilo rice or wheat, then to measure that kgs, here highest unit is kg, but kg is not sufficient to measure that. Okay, then there is highest unit also, that is called, to measure weight there is highest unit, that is called quintal. This is also very important unit, quintal. So you know here highest unit is kilo. So how many kilo makes quintal? 1 quintal is equal to 100 kilogram, that is kg. Okay, this also writes somewhere else. 1 quintal is equal to 100 kg. Quintal is the unit to measure weight, which is the highest, more in proportion. Okay, quintal. After quintal also there is weight, that we will see afterwards. Just you keep it in mind. Quintal, 1 quintal means 100 kg. If the weight is 100 kg, then it is equal to 1 quintal. Okay. So this thing keep it in mind, write this in your notebook properly, write neatly and try to memorize. Understood? After that, let's solve exercise 11, which is based on this conversion of units. Okay? So we are going to convert one unit into another, smaller unit into bigger or bigger unit into smaller. Okay? And to convert the units, this triangle is most important. Okay? once you memorize this triangle, then your work will be easy. Understood? Now see the first question, exercise 11. 3567 centimeter is equal to dash meter plus dash decimeter plus dash centimeter. Means this is centimeter here, centi. Okay, so that centimeter we have to convert first into meter, then decimeter, and then remaining there will be centimeter. Okay, so let's do it. First we convert into meter. See, pay attention very carefully. 3567 centimeter is equal to dash dash meter. First we'll convert into meter, then whatever remain that will be converted into decimeter, and whatever remain after that it will be centimeter itself. Okay, so now see, 3567 centimeter is equal to dash dash meter. See here, centimeter means it is here, and centimeter we have to convert into meter, means we have to come down, correct? From centimeter, how many steps you will come down? Two steps, okay? One and two. See this triangle. Two steps you have to come down. Two steps, when you have to come down, that means we divide. Now, two steps you have to come down means divide by 100. Divide by 100. That is, you know, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Okay? 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So we have to convert centimeter to meter. Opposite, we have to come down. That means we will divide by 100. So 3567 centimeter is equal to how many meter? 3567. Let us divide this by 100. 3567 divide by 100 meter. Okay, 3567 centimeter is equal to how many meter? 3567 divide by 100 meter means what? To convert centimeter into meter, we divided this centimeter by 100. And why we divided by 100? See here, this is centimeter here, this is meter, means we have to come down. Two steps we have to come down, and whenever we have to come down, we divide, and two steps, so 10 times 100, okay? So, when we divide 3567 meter, what will we get? Answer? Divide by 100, see, 3567 divide by 100. It's very easy, I will show you shortcut also, but now see here, 356, so 3s are 300, 100 threes are 300, remain 56, 7 came down, 5s are 500, okay, remain 67. See now, 35 is the quotient, 67 is the remainder, so 35 meter, 67 centimeter. Understood? There is shortcut also for this. Whenever we divide by 100, 10 or 1000, we have learned that division. Last two digits will be your remainder, and first two digits or remaining digits will be your quotient. Understood? So here, last two digits means number formed by last two digits is 67, it is remainder. That will be centimeter itself. And the 35 which is quotient, that will be meter, exactly meter, okay? So here 35 meter we got, and remain 67 centimeter. That 67 centimeter take again here. That 65 or 67 centimeter we have to convert into decimeter. What is meaning of this, you know? In this 3567 centimeter, how many complete meter are there? Then how many complete decimeter are there? And the remaining will be centimeter, okay? So when first when we converted centimeter into meter, we got how many complete meter? 35 complete meter, okay? 35 complete meter and 67 remain. Now in this 67 centimeter, there are some decimeters. So how many those decimeter are there? That will remove out, and remaining will be centimeter itself. Okay. So now this 67 centimeter we have to convert into decimeter. DM, decimeter. Okay. So you know 1 centimeter means how many decimeter? See, where is centi and deci? Okay, only one step. That means 1 centimeter is equal to 10 decimeter. Okay, and we have to come down. Similarly, 67 centimeter is equal to 67. What? Divide or multiply? Centi deci. You have to come down. That means divide. Divide by 10. Decimeter is equal to, now there is divide by 10 means now there is 1 0, that means the number formed by last 1 digit will be your remainder, that will be here centimeter, and 6, the remaining, that is 6, will be your decimeter. Okay, understood? Remainder will remain in same unit and the portion will change into the decimeter. Okay. Now here in this 67 centimeter we got 6 decimeter and 7 centimeter left back. That only we have to find. See how many meter plus how many decimeter plus how many centimeter. So at the end we will write 3567 centimeter is equal to how many meter? 35 meter plus how many decimeter? 6 decimeter plus how many centimeter left? 7 centimeter. Understood? This is your final answer. Okay? Once again I repeat, 3567 centimeter is equal to dash meter plus dash decimeter plus dash centimeter. Means what? In this total 3567 centimeter length, this is length, okay? How many meter are there? How many complete meter are there? How many complete decimeter are there? And how many centimeter are there? So first what we have done, this 3567 meter we converted into a centimeter, we converted into meter. And to convert centimeter into meter, we divided this by 100. Because 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. And we have to come down, so division. Okay? So when we divided by 100, we got 35. The quotient 35. Quotient is complete meter, okay? And remainder is centimeter itself. Now again, 35 complete meter we got, 67 centimeter remain. That 67 centimeter we converted into decimeter. So in this 67 centimeter, how many decimeter are there? 6 decimeter are there, okay? Complete 6 decimeter are there, and remaining are centimeter. You know 1 decimeter is equal to, see here, 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeter, okay? 10 centimeter. So we divided by 10, so we got complete 6 decimeter and 7 centimeter left back. So 3567 centimeter is equal to 35 meter plus 6 decimeter plus 7 centimeter, okay? Next. 43 kg into gram. See here, we have to convert kg, kilogram into gram. Where is kilogram? At the bottom, okay? And kilogram we have to convert into gram, means we have to go up. Here there is gram. Your kilogram. How many steps you have to go up? 1, 2, 3. 3 steps you have to go up. 3 steps means 10 multiplied by 10 multiplied by 10. So 1 kg is equal to how many gram? 1000 grams. See, 10, 10, 10. 1 and how many is in 10? 10 is 100, 10 is 1000. So 1 kg means 1000 gram. So 43 kg is equal to 43 right here. And multiply and divide. From down we have to go up. When we have to go up, we need to do multiplication. Okay, that is multiply by 1000 gram. Okay, now 43 into 1000, 43, and these 3 zeros, 1000. Finish. So 43 kilogram is equal to how many gram? 43,000 gram. 1 kg means 1000 gram. So 43 kg means 43,000 gram. Okay. Next, third one. A quarter of liter into milliliter. A quarter of liter into milliliter. Now see here. We have to convert liter into milliliter. Liter into milliliter. Okay. Now you know 1 liter means how many milliliter? Where is liter? Here. Milliliter? Here. How many steps are there? 1, 2, 3. 3 steps means 10 tens are 100, 100 tens are 1000. So 1 liter means how many milliliter? 1000 milliliter. Okay. Just keep it in mind always. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Now this a quarter, half, three quarter, we have done in the first chapter. If you remember, a quarter or half or three quarters, okay? So see now, 1 liter means 1000 milliliter. Then a quarter of liter. A quarter of liter means how many milliliter, okay? Now, a quarter means, if you divide it, you know, quarter means, this is one whole. And when we divide it into 4 equal parts, each part is called a quarter, 1/4. 1/4 means a quarter. So this 1000 ml, which is 1 liter, which is equal to 1 liter. When we divide 4 into 4 equal parts, in each part, how many ml will be there? Can you tell me? That is 1000 divided by 4. Divide 1000 into 4 equal parts. So divide by 4. 4 2s are 8. 2 remain, 0 came down, 4 5s are 20, 0 came down, 4 0s are 0, 250. So in each part there will be 250 ml. Okay. This should be on your term. Why? Because immediately you should know a quarter of 1000 is how many? 250. I have told you this pattern. A quarter of 100 is 25. A quarter of 100 is 25. Half of 100 is 50. Okay. 3/4 means 3 quarter of 100 is 75. Similarly here also, a quarter of 1000 is 250. Means 25 and 0. Okay. This 0 will be increases as per the 0 increase here in the after 1000. Okay. So now the quarter, a quarter of 1000 ml means 1 quarter, that is 250 ml, okay? So, a quarter of liter is equal to 250 milliliter. If they would have asked 3 quarters of liter, means how many milliliter? Then 250 plus 250, that is 750 milliliter, okay? Half of a liter means how many milliliter? Half means 2 quarters, means this half and this half. So half means 250 plus 250, 500 ml, okay? Pause this video, write this. Two more examples we will see. Whenever we are going to solve the examples of conversion of units, this triangle should be there. This triangle should be there beside you or with you. Okay? Now see next. Example number 4. Plus dash dash dm sorry, dm not deca meter. Dm means decimeter, okay? Deca, for deca, you will write deca completely. Plus digest meter. These two examples we will solve. Now see, 12 and half hectometers convert into decimeters. Hectometers into decimeters you have to convert. Okay? Where is hectometer? Here. Deci here. Means 1, 2, 3. 3 steps you have to go up. Okay? That means 1 decimeter dm is equal to how many hectometer? 1000 hectometer. 3 steps. So 1000. Okay? 3 zeros after 1. 1 decimeter is equal to 1000 hectometer. So now first 12 and half hectometer. Okay? First we will convert 12 hectometer. You know, 1 decimeter is equal to dash dash. Sorry, 1 hectometer is equal to dash dash decimeter, 1000 decimeter. Okay? 1 hectometer is equal to 1000 decimeter. So, this 12 hectometer is equal to how many decimeter then? 12 multiply and divide by 1000. See, hecto, deci, you have to go up. Up means you have to multiply. So, 12 multiply by 1000 hectometer, decimeter, sorry. So, 12 into 1000, 12,000 decimeter. Okay? First, what we have done, this 12, complete, it was complete 12. So, 12 hectometer, first we converted into decimeter, we got 12,000 decimeter. 12 hectometer means, is equal to 12,000 decimeter. Now, half hectometer remain. Now, half hectometer means, half of hectometer. You know, 1 hectometer means how many decimeter? 1000. And just now I showed you the parts of 1000 when it is divided into 4 equal parts. Okay? 1 hectometer means 1000 decimeter. Then half hectometer means how many decimeter? Can you tell me immediately? Half means divided by 2. That is 500 decimeter. Okay? So this 12,000 decimeter and 500 decimeter we have to add, because so 12 and half, we have to find 12 and half decimeter. Half hectometer is equal to, we have to convert 12 and half hectometer into decimeter. So 12 hectometer means 12,000 decimeter and half hectometer means 500 decimeter. So that is, that will be added together. That is 12,500 hectometer together, okay? So the final answer is 12,500 hectometer, sorry, decimeter. Decimeter, okay? Understood? 12 and half hectometer is equal to 12,500 decimeter. So in this, 12 decimeter, okay? So together it is 12 and half hectometer is equal to 12,500 decimeter. Understood? Next. 567 meter is equal to dash hectometer plus dash decameter plus dash meter. This. There is meter. Given is meter and we have to convert into hecto, deca and meter. Means we have to come down. Okay, that means we have to do division. So first we have to convert 567 meter into hectometer. Okay, so now we must know that 1 hectometer means how many meter? 1 hectometer means how many meter? How many steps you have to come down? 1 and 2. 2 steps means 2 zeros after 1. 100 meter. 1 hectometer means 100 meter. Okay, and we have to come down. So 567 meter is equal to 567. What? Multiply by 100 or divide by 100. We have to come down. Down is division, okay? Divide by 100 hectometer. Okay? Now, 567 divided by 100. When we divide 567 by 100, what we will get? Portion? question remainder will be 67 because two zeros are there. That means the number formed by last two digits will be your remainder. That will be meter itself, and question 5 will be hectometer. So in this 567 meter, how many hectometers are there? Complete 5 hectometers are there. Okay. Now 67 meter remain. That 67 meter we will convert first into decameter. Okay. Now you know meter to deca, only one step. That means 1 decameter is equal to how many meter? 10 meter. Okay. So 67 meter is equal to 67 divided or multiplied by 10, coming down. Okay, so divide by 10. Okay, so 67 divided by 10, how many complete decameter you will get here? Divide by 10, so number formed by last one digit, 10, na? So one digit will be remainder, that is 7 meter itself, and remain 6, that will be your decameter. And remaining meter, that will be 1 in the end. Okay, so 567 meter is equal to how many HM, how many hectometer? 5 HM plus how many decameter? Yes, 6 decameter plus how many meter? 7 meter radius. Understood? Once again I repeat, 567 meter is equal to dash hectometer plus dash decameter plus dash meter. Okay, means when there is plus from here, plus means when there is plus between these units, same number 567 meter only we have to convert into hectometer, and remaining we have to convert into decameter. Okay, in this way. So 567 meter is equal to dash dash hectometer, you know, meter to hectometer means coming down, meter to hectometer, not hectometer to meter. We have to convert meter into hectometer, so we have to come down. Okay, two steps, come down, that means divide by 100. Okay, so when we divide 567 by 100, we got 5 as a quotient, that will be your hectometer, 67 remainder, that will be your meter. Again 67 meter remain, that 67 convert into decameter. Okay, not again 567. If there is not plus sign, separately you have to convert into hectometer, then again 567 meter into decameter, and again 567 into meter, then that will be different. Okay, here there is positive plus sign, that means same number we have to convert into hectometer, again remaining we have to convert into decameter. So 67 meter is equal to dash decameter, you know, 1 decameter here, only one step, that means 10 meter, and coming down, so divide by 10. So when we divided 67 by 10, we got 6 quotient, that will be your decameter, and remainder is 7, that will be your meter. Okay, so 5 hectometer, 6 decameter, and 7 meter. Understood? Watch this video within the 1 hour 9 to 10, and after that from 10:30 to 11:30 you have doubt session. So whatever doubts are there, remove the doubts, write those doubts on one page, and within that 1 hour you have to clear your doubts. Okay, write this now in your notebook. This triangle is very important. Okay, so thank you for today, and have a nice day.